Okay, Dave here again. You've seen a few of my videos on streaming media players. I first had the Retail Plus unit from Walmart. I ended up selling that, and then I bought a Boxy. And if you check out my videos, you'll see a video on the Boxy. Well, it didn't last very long. I took it back within a couple of days because it wouldn't really perform the way I had hoped. Really, there was very few movies on it, unless you're a Netflix subscriber. So, and what I really, really wanted to do with it was go to YouTube, watch videos, movies off of YouTube, which it could do that, but it locked up a number of times. And it had no browser, okay? So today I went out and got this. It's the Sony Internet Player with Google TV. So this unit has Google Chrome as the browser, so it will work for what I intend on using it for. It also has, it's like an Android device, so you can go and download apps from the Google Play Store, okay, and various other things, but it comes in a very small box. Google TV. So this is the model NSZ-GS7. So I'm going to go ahead and open it up here. And from the reviews that I watched on this unit, the one really, really nice thing it has is this remote control. It's backlit. Has a touchpad on the front, so it's pretty, really a slick device. So I'm going to go ahead and unbox that, and it's got a really nice rubbery key feel to it. A nice little trackpad here, and it's actually pretty cool if you ask me. It's a Bluetooth remote, so it doesn't require you be sitting inside in front of the TV or the box. So we'll just set that aside for now. Bag back in here. Now the unit itself is very, very tiny. As you can see from the size of my hand, the box is very, very small. The actual player has a very nice shiny finish on it, like you can see yourself in the finish. It's got almost like a it almost looks like carbon fiber. Very sleek looking. And then on the back you have all the jacks and stuff. So here's where your power cord goes. You have two USB ports, LAN connection, IR blaster for extending the remote capabilities, digital optical audio out, and then two HDMI plugs. One is in, one is out. So I'm just going to be using the out because I don't have a cable box. So now we'll just see what else we got at the bottom of this. There's the IR blaster unit, power cord, two Sony batteries, of course, for the remote control, and a nice instruction booklet. So I'm going to go ahead now and set this baby up, hook it up to the TV, and just give you a slight small demonstration of how it works. And hopefully in an hour or so, or 20 minutes, I'll be watching a movie or your YouTube video. You never know. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do here is install the batteries. So there's a little push to open button on the side of the remote control. And the cover around it comes off, and you just insert the two batteries, like so. Then you put the cover back on. Just snaps back into place. So there you have it. So now we're going to go and play. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and hook up the power cord and the HDMI cable connected. There's the Sony logo. And Google TV. That's pretty cool. Graphic going there on the screen. Okay, so now I put the buttons or the batteries in the remote, so yeah, we want English. See, there's the, touchpad, so you can move around the screen and enter. Remote tutorial, arrows and back. Move the focus. I'm not sure what that's supposed to mean. Okay, touchpad, we got that. Scroll. Quick start. Do you want to enable quick start? Now I'm going to go for the longer setup. Okay, maximize your screen size. Connecting to the internet. Signing into your Google account. Setting up your TV service. Setting up your TV and AV receiver control. So what you want to do is now you stretch this out till it maximizes the screen size. Right. So this is maximizing the actual size of the screen. Okay, so I've done that. Okay. Sony legal notices. I'm going to go with a wireless internet connection for now. So it does find the internet connection, no problem. So now I'm going to probably have to put in a password here. Okay, so I'm going to go and enter the password and be right back. Okay, so get the password in. So now I think I just move down here to connect. And it should connect. Okay, so I'm connected now to the internet. Okay, so sign in with your Google account. Okay, so I just enter that now. PC board. Oop, I spelled it wrong. How did I do that? Big fingers, maybe? So at gmail.com. Cool. Works really well. So I'm just going to enter my password now. Okay, so I have entered the password and now I'm signing into my Google account. So I definitely want these two options selected. I'm going to hit next. Now I believe this will restore all my email stuff. Automatically send usage reports. Yeah, well, I'm always friendly with Google, so they're good to me. Okay, and that should be the correct time. Okay, connect your set-top box. I do not have a box. Next. Do I want to control my TV with this remote control? Not right now. Do I have an AV receiver? I'm going to say use my TV speaker. You can modify the configurations in the settings. Please wait while we optimize your settings based on your specifications. Your screen may go blank for a few moments. Okay, so shutting down. It's pretty cool, pretty nice remote. Really like the remote. Very ergonomic feel in your hand. Okay, so let's see if it all works now. So I should be able to browse the internet, watch YouTube videos, YouTube movies, Crackle movies. The nice thing is it has Google Play, so you can go get the apps that you normally would have. I believe you can play games on it too somehow, but I'm not sure exactly how yet. Okay, so okay, powered by Google. Congratulations, your TV just got smarter. I hope I am too. Okay, the home key gives you quick access to application notifications no matter where you are on the NSZ GS7. Okay, download apps and games from the Google Store and make your TV what you want it to be. Press the search button to find local websites. Oh, it says an update is available. Press the menu key to reveal options. Experience videos. Okay, so there we go. It's weird how it got my name in there and everything. So if I push the home button, it says it's 612. Boy, it is. It's 612. It says I have 2 emails. Wow. This is cool. I don't have to turn the computer on to check my email. So menu, customize home items, system settings, updating Google Play movie and TV, successfully updated. I'm not doing nothing. It's doing it all by itself. So let's see, network, video input, picture and sound, search, applications. Let's just go in there for a sec. Do I want to allow them for unknown sources? Well, I have this checked off on my phone, so I better go here. Okay, so manage applications, running services, development. There should be an update for the should be a way to update this already. Date and time, about, okay, system info. So I wonder how you get the update. Oh, right there, system updates. So I'm gonna check, see if there's an update here. Says it's downloading release 6. So I'm on the Wi-Fi connection right now, so this may not be extremely fast, but fast enough. Yeah, I can't say enough for the remote control. The remote's very nice, very good feel to it. So I better pause this video now while it's updating here, and that way you're not sitting here watching it do an update, and then I'll boot her back up afterwards. Okay, so I got the latest update. I think it was 12 November 20th was the version of this. So right now it's just reinstalling it and booting. So Basically, it's telling me right now, do not unplug the box. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the lights out here to get rid of some of the glare on the TV here. And I should be able to start surfing here in a second. Anyways, this might take a few minutes. I'll just pause the video and start it up again in a minute. Okay, so that screen finished. Now it's booting back up again. You know, one thing I forgot to do today was go get some beer. So I'm gonna go to the Play Store. System successfully updated. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the Play Store. Of course, I accept, right? And I want some apps. So, what do I want first? Triage was a good unit, a good. Mistake there. So let's see if we got it here, triage.60 results at the top. I wonder how you get over to that. Okay, how about Angry Birds? Everybody likes Angry Birds, right? I haven't got the Star Wars version of this, so I'm going to get Star Wars Angry Birds. Angry Birds Star Wars Wars Guide. What? How can this be? Okay, well, let's try Angry Birds then. Well, here's Angry Beavers. Let's try that. No, that's not what we want. Anyways, I'm not going to mess around with this too much long because don't want to bore you guys to death. So, maybe I'll go back to the menu. Live TV, I wonder what that's all about. Anyways, there's the YouTube. Application update, newer version of YouTube app is available. So we can go ahead and update that. So anyways, I'm going to go ahead and play around with this and maybe show you a couple of features in a bit. Okay? Okay, so to watch a movie, a really, really good website is Crackle. So right here you just kind of go through. There's so many movies every month. And you pick the movie you want to watch. That simple. So I'm going to watch one of these. Stripes would be good. This one right here. So that's under all genres. You can go into action, horror, music, sci-fi, thriller. Let's just go into action here and have a peek. Most popular. Recently added full length. So here there's five pages. Each page has got like 16 movies on it, so that's quite a bit of movies to watch. Anyways, I'm just going to go back to the main menu here. So that there's the Chrome browser there. I wonder if I can save this. So I would take it, this is all your apps here, so Android Assistant, Clock, there's Crackle right there, Live TV, Photos, Play Movies and TV, Music Unlimited, Solitaire, Track ID, Video Unlimited. did Sony Entertainment. So let's go check out the Sony Entertainment app. So there you go. Certain ones are all Sony. National and Public Radio. Oh, there's Lance Armstrong's Idiot. Whatever. No thanks. Let's try this Control TV and see what happens. See what we get. So the picture quality on this is really, really, really awesome. I've actually watched a movie on this already, so that's pretty cool. You can actually control your TV with your handheld remote or your actual cell phone. So I'm going to hit back and then back again because there's nothing really in there. Let's check out Video Unlimited. So, it looks like this is all movies too. Let me just see here if this plays. So here's Death Race 3. Yeah, so you can actually go in and play this. Or no, this one you have to pay for. So we'll get out of there. Anyways, let's go check out YouTube. See if we can pull up the video. Okay, so here's YouTube. Now, it's a really well set up browser on this device. Internet player. So, unfortunately, I can't show you any of these, but I could go to mine. Let me see. There's my YouTube here, so. I want to sign in using my regular account. These are my videos, so I'm not sure. Might actually have to play around with this playlist. Yeah, it is. There's my videos there. So if I go to uploads, there we go. So here's the one of my daughter on the bus. And the, like I said, the picture quality of this is just awesome. Now this video is not very clear, so it's not a good example. Stuff on here.
That's what I wouldn't mind right now, right there, one of those. I'm starving. Anyways. Okay, so this time we bought... The extra, extra large Panzerotti from Bo's Pizza.
Okay, so this is,
And oh my god, look at this.
Pausing a little
There's
bit.
There's my plate. It's not gonna fit on the plate. Wait, what? How's that gonna work?
Yeah. Switching to low quality video. See? So it's doing it automatically for me.
How's that gonna work? Oh, 16-inch Panzerotti.
Yeah,
oh
like
my god, that
right
is going to be good.
So there's the
home
theater I'm using right now.
I'm going to be doing a...
So it's all integrated right into this. Here's YouTube movies, so you can watch, let's say I want to find a good movie, animation, no thanks, comedy, you just scroll down through there and pick a movie. I believe this is movies. Anyways, you guys have probably seen enough, and I want to get on and play with this thing, so I have you sitting here watching me use this thing all night, so. Anyways, these are some live channels here. Live women's basketball. Let's see what this is, options, yeah. It's pretty cool though. Works really, really well. The picture quality is awesome. The sound is really, really good as well. So I'm mighty pleased with this. I'd like to see a couple more apps here. Available. So yeah, there's lots of, there's a few apps here, but you know, let's go into StatPix and see what they've got here. Still Pond, HD, TV, Landscape, Twitter, I believe Facebook is on here. So yeah, that's one I should look for. So I'm just going to type that in Facebook. FaceTime. Facebook Messenger. So there's one there that my buddy really likes, the IMDb Movies and TV. So I'm just going to install that for now. Whoops. So I ended up going back. Just hit the wrong button. Anyways, I wanted to get Facebook, so I'm going to search for that again. Facebook like, my Facebook, Facebook friend watcher. That sounds really cool. Solitaire. Evernote, I've got that. So yeah, there's that thing I was going to install. Let's see if we can do that. So we go over here, click install, accept and download. So it's very, very fast as well. It doesn't take very, very long to download any of these apps. I know a good one that would be in here is Tiny Chat. So Tiny Chat, let's see if it comes up. Well, that's right, I've got a webcam. At least I don't have any luck with that. So anyways, you kind of get the idea, right? So I'm going to post this on the YouTube now. And NBC Real Time. What? Let's try that one out. Real-time Google TV app. And also, the other thing I noticed is the color is awesome. You really can't see it on the webcam, but the colors on the screen are, you know, really, really good, very clear. Discover Earth. Fox Business for TV. Fox News. Oh, here we go. So I can get these apps and get news right on the TV screen. CNN money. So the apps are, you know, basically just like a normal cell phone or which movie, a tablet that runs on Android. Here's the Weather Channel. Recipe search, Google Play Music, TV Portal, Air, Droid, I wonder what that's. Beacon Reader, what? TalkBack. So I've got TalkBack on here, I need to update that. Scanner radio, let's try that. This might be something. Let's get out of here and just check out some of these apps work. So I believe I go menu, and then I believe this is apps here. Yeah, right. So there's Google Chrome. So. Works just like any other browser, really. So 401 pile up. Something happened there yesterday. So here's Toronto Star. Everybody watch this here. Check this out. So there's a complete Toronto Star story on the car pileup yesterday. Just happened. Look at that. Oops, went too far. So now I should be able to click on this picture and see just this picture. Thinking. I may be wrong. Oh, there's an asshole. See him? Rob Ford. What an asshole. 70 car pileup just south of here. Friday night. So yeah, you can pretty well look up anything you want on the internet. So, there you have it. Go out and buy one. It's a Google TV internet player by Sony. The model number is NSZ-5 or GS7. So anyways, there you go. I hope you enjoy it. One last thing I'm going to check here is my Gmail. Let's see if it works. Sending request. There's my Gmail. Look at that. So pretty cool. Thanks for watching, guys. Talk to you later.